Hello students, in today's class we are going to continue with chapter 6 sets. Today we will discuss about subsets. Let A and B be any two sets, then A is said to be subset of B if every element of A is also an element of B. It is written as A subset B. This is the sign of subset. So we call it as is a subset of, right? Here I have written A subset of B. Okay, it means all the elements of A are from set B, from the elements of set B. Now let us take an example. If A is a set with elements 1, 2, 3 and B is a set with elements 1 to 10, all elements. Okay, so here we can see 1, 2, 3 is a part of set B because 1, 2, 3 up to 10 are lying in B. So all the elements of A are from set B. So we will write it as A subset of B. Okay, next thing is supersets. If A is a subset of B, then B is the superset of A. Now A, the smaller set is known as subset. We know that. The bigger set from which we have written the subset, that is known as superset. It means B is superset of A. Okay, the B is the bigger set. So this open mouth we can see is towards B. So here B is the superset and A is the subset. Alright, so let us take this an example. B is equal to 1 to 10 all elements, and then A is a subset of it, that is 2, 5, 7, 9. So all the elements 2, 5, 7, 9 are present there in B. So B is a bigger set, so B is a superset. Alright, so we will write here B is superset of A. So what is A? A is the subset. Okay, next thing we have proper subsets. What are proper subsets? All the subsets of a set other than set itself are called proper subsets. Means when we write subsets of a set, we do not write the set itself. Okay, so except set itself, rest all the subsets when we write. That means that is proper subset. Okay, so this you will understand with the example that we will do next. Next we have number of subsets. The first thing is how to find the number of possible subsets of the given set. If a set has n elements, then the total number of subsets is 2 raised to power n. What is n here? N is the number of elements. Number of elements means the cardinal number. Okay, so here we will find the cardinal number and then we will do it as 2 raised to power that cardinal number. So the whatever answer you will get, it means you can write that many subsets for that given set. Now let us understand it with the help of example. Let A is equal to ABC. Now in this set A, here we can see there are 3 elements. Okay, so we will write n is equal to 3. Now the formula is to find number of subsets is 2 raised to power n. So it means when we will write here 2 raised to power n is 3, 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 3 means 2 is multiplied 3 times, so 8. It means for this set A, we can write 8 subsets. Okay, so what are those 8 subsets? So we will write now, phi is always the first subset. Okay, so because phi is subset of every set, empty set. Okay, then second we will write all elements individually first. Like here we have A, B, C, 3 elements. So it means one subset will be only A, then B, then C. So what we have written? One element in each subset. Then we will write two elements. So two elements possible are AB, then BC and then AC. Okay, so here now the last subset is always set itself. So that is A, B and C set itself. So here you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So in total we have written 8 subsets. Okay. So this is the way we write subset. First we write 1 element, then 2 elements, then 3 elements. So it depends upon the number of elements present in the set. I hope you have understood how to write subsets of a set. Now the thing was the proper subset. Here, as I told you, in proper subset we write all other subsets except set itself. Now here set itself, like in this example we have done ABC. It means if we do not write this only ABC, rest 7 will be proper subsets. Okay, so here next we are given number of proper subsets. If a set has n elements, the number of proper subset is 2 raised to power n minus 1. This minus 1 is for set itself. I hope you have understood this thing. Now in the same example of ABC, here cardinal number is 3, we all know. So how many number of proper subsets here we will have? 2 raised to power 3 minus 1. So 8 minus 1 means proper 7 subsets we will have. And these proper subsets are, first is empty set, then subsets with one element each, that means A, B, C, and then two elements AB, BC and AC. So these 7 subsets are proper subsets of the given set A. Okay, we are not writing set itself in it. Okay, next thing is universal set. What do you understand by universal set? Any set which contains all elements of various sets is called a universal set. It means a set from where we can derive many other sets, that is known as universal set. It is denoted by this sign, that is I, or capital U we write for it. Okay, so if we take xi as a universal set, let us take this an example, set of natural numbers. Okay, this is a universal set. Then A is a set here, all even numbers. B is a set with all odd numbers. P is a set with all prime numbers. So we can see here A, B, P. These three sets are part of xi because set of natural numbers contain all even, odd and prime numbers. Okay, so xi is the bigger most set and A, B, P and are smaller sets here, and all the elements of A, B and P set are part of xi. Okay, so xi is a universal set here. Next thing is complement of a set. Let U be the universal set, then A be any other set such that A is subset of U, means A is part of U. Then complement of set A is the set consisting those elements of U which do not belong to A. Okay, so in the complement set we write those elements which we are not having in A. They are present in U but are not present in A. So it is denoted by A dash. This is for A complement, or we can write A power C or A bar. So these are signs to write complement of the set. Now let us take this an example. U is a universal set in which we have elements 1 to 10. Okay, A is a set with elements 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So here we can see A is subset of U. Now what will be A complement? Now all those elements of U which are not present in A, we will write in A complement. So here elements will be 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9, because these are the elements which are not there in A but they are present in U. So all those remaining elements we are writing in A complement. I hope you have understood what is complement. Complement means remaining elements of universal set except A. Okay, now let us start with exercise 6.2. The first question is, Let X is a set with elements 1 to 10. It is a universal set. A is a set with elements 3, 4, 6, 8. Now you know what is a complement. A complement means all the remaining elements of the universal set. Okay. So here all the remaining elements means except elements of A. So we will write here 1, 2, 3 is there. We will not write 4 is there, but 5 is not there. Okay. Then 6 is there, but 7. Then 9 and 10. So these are the elements which are not present in A but are there in X. Okay. Then second question is, how many subsets in all are there of a set having cardinal number 3? Now we know when we have to write the number of subsets. So how we write? Number of subsets will be equal to 2 raised to power n. Now n is 3 here. It means 2 raised to power 3. That means 8. It means 8 subsets we can write for cardinal number 3. Okay. Third question is, how many proper subsets in all are there in a set having number of elements 4? Now we know number of proper subsets will be equal to 2 raised to power n minus 1. When n is 4, we will write 2 raised to power 4 minus 1. 2 raised to power 4 means 16 minus 1. That is 15 proper. Question number 4 is, if I is a set of all integers, it is a universal set, then B is a set in which we have positive integer, x, so that x is a positive integer. Now in B complement, we all know what to write. We will write all the remaining elements of I. In remaining elements, we will be having negative integers and 0. So we will write it as B complement is equal to x, so that x is a negative integer. And 0. Alright. Then question number 5 is, given U is a universal set here, set with elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. A is a set with elements 2, 4, 6. Then B is a set belongs to U, means it is a subset of U. And then X does not belong to A. X does not belong to A means 2, 4, 6 we will not write in that set. So, what are the elements of set B? It means elements of set B are, B is equal to 1, 3, 5 and 7. Alright, because 2, 4, 6 are there. So, we will write B, 1, 3, 5, 7. Are A and B equivalent sets? No. Why no? Because cardinal number of A is 3, but cardinal number of B is 4. Because for equivalent sets, cardinal number should be same. Here we do not have same cardinal number, so they are not equivalent sets. Are A and B subsets of U? Yes. Because all elements of A, they are part of U, as well as all elements of B are also part of U. Okay. Question number 7 is, write all possible proper subsets. The set is having one element, that is 1 only. Now it means cardinal number is 1 only. And in proper subset, we write 2 raised to power n minus 1. So here 2 raised to power 1 minus 1 means 2 minus 1. It means only one element should be there. Now what are proper subsets? Now if we know, we will not write set itself. It means only phi is proper subset here. Okay. Only phi is there. Then second part is C and D. So there are two elements C, D. So n is 2. So number of proper subsets, again 2 raised to power n minus 1 means 2 raised to power 2 minus 1. 3 proper subsets here we will have. So first is always 5 empty set. Then we will have one element individually. So these are 3 proper subsets here. Okay. Then question number 8 is write all possible subsets. Now fourth part, there are 3 elements 0, 2, 4. Now the cardinal number is 3. And we know number of subsets will be equal to 2 raised to power n. That means 2 raised to power 3, that is 8 subsets. Okay. So what are 8 subsets? First is always 5. Then one element each. Then we will write two elements. So 0, 2, then 2, 4, then 0, 4. Okay. And the last is always set itself, that is 0, 2, 4. Okay. So this is the way we will write 8 subsets. 10th question is, let U is a universal set with elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 12. Then A is a set with odd numbers 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. B set having elements 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. And C is having elements 1, 5, 9. Then we have to find, first is A complement. A complement means accept the elements of A, the remaining elements in U. Okay. So we will write here, A is equal to 0, then 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 and last 12. Okay. And now NA complement in second part. NA complement means cardinal number of this A complement set. So here we can see we have here 7 elements in this set. So cardinal number is 7. Now in B complement we will write all the elements of U except B. Okay. So here we will leave 0, then 1, then 3, then 5, then 7, then after 9, 10, 11 and 12. Okay. Same way we will write for C complement, except 3 elements of set C, all remaining elements of U. 0, then 2, 3, 4, then 6, 7, 8, then leaving 9, we have to write 10, 11 and 12. So this is the way we write complements and the cardinal number of that particular set. I hope you have understood. Okay. So in the same manner, you will complete all the remaining questions of this exercise 6.2. Thank you, children.